Okay, welcome to my presentation on access arrangements, about when and how to make decisions. So the reason behind having access arrangements is from the Equality Act 2010. The rationale behind it is to make sure those learners with any type of special needs, education needs, disabilities, are able to have reasonable adjustments, which will mean that they will not have a substantial disadvantage compared to those who are not disabled in any type of exam situation. So the categories under which somebody may be able to get access arrangements would be a social, mental and emotional needs, sensory and physical needs, and communication interaction needs, which I'll look at in a minute. Those do not require a Form 8, but other types of evidence. Those four are Form 8, are cognition and learning needs, which includes extra time at 25 and 50% and a reader and a scribe, and evidence is required for that. So, 1, 2 and 3, for that, any school who's looking to give access arrangements for somebody under this would need to make sure they've got additional evidence. So that would be information from CAMHS, a psychologist, a hospital consultant, anybody at all who could give the right information for emotional needs particularly. Under the other areas for speech and language, a therapist, if they're on an educational healthcare plan, obviously that would be part of the evidence for getting the access arrangements. Under 4, where evidence is needed, there are 4 points where you don't actually need to fill it under the Form 8, but this could still be given as support, which are rest breaks, word processing, a prompt, read aloud, and reading pen, which I'll look at in a second. But those where you're going to require some evidence in order to get those are for the Form 8, are for extra time, a scribe, a voice software, a reader, or an oral language modifier. So, supervised breaks then. These should be looked at first before you consider anything under extra time. This will be for somebody with poor concentration skills, extreme stress, any type of medical or psychological reasons, so emotional and social difficulties. Somebody under this should be having rest breaks to see how that allows them to access exams much better. At this point, an originator would have to accompany them, and a time would be have to set by the SENCO. Often I've seen that in practice, that's often played around with different exams to see if there's a particular timing that works best, but it's not part of extra time. A word processor, if this is the normal way a student works, i.e. it's reached a stage where because of their handwriting, they're using in certain lessons a word processor to do their work, then this could be something that could be looked at as part of their exam process, as long as there's no spell check or predicted text. But if that is going to be allowed, then they're going to have to lose all the spag marks. A prompt can be used where you've got somebody who loses their concentration and distracts easily, or seems to go off task, or isn't sure what they're doing. And again, that's something that a centre can experiment with a little bit to see how a student reacts to that and if it makes a difference to their end result. And they would need to provide the evidence for that on a paper trail. But again, it doesn't need to be on a Form 8 from JCQ's point of view. And lastly, you've got read aloud reading pen, good for students who struggle to understand and they need to sort of section down what they're reading. And that may help some, but it may not help others. It depends how significant their reading challenge is. Okay, so Form 8 then, the section that actually does need to be filled in and sent off to JCQ to actually get your access arrangements. The first section needs to be completed by the SENCO potentially, or if it is a specialist assessor, it needs to be in the centre who's got the knowledge and information. Really, ideally, between year 7 and 9, there should be evidence being built up before you fill in this form, so that this form should then be fairly straightforward because you've got the information in the child's file. So information about their challenges and difficulties, anything that's taken place even prior to coming to your school, interventions, tracking, observations, clearly any form of diagnosis that's taken place should all be filled in the first section. The second section, it would be the impact this is having on them in school, what observations from any teachers and any type of changes that have been made in order to make that sort of candidate's life a little bit easier. And many of them have worked. And the last thing is the candidate's normal way of working. So it may well be that certain access arrangements have been trialled already, so you can put in place and comment on those. And finally, you've got the recommendations, which is going to go with the tests. So any tests that you've carried out to look at their reading speeds, to look at their concentration and memory. This, along with the history that we just talked about, will be used to make recommendations about what will be best for them in terms of maybe a reader, scriber, or extra time, or all three. So the test results, from the point of view of the test centre, the test papers are not needed for an inspection, but the centre does need to keep a copy of the actual format and have it in the file. So with all the information that they've compiled together regarding access arrangements, but the actual access arrangements can be done online. And if the specialist assessor is employed outside the centre, then they only have to complete the last section C with the tests. The rest of it should be filled in by the centre SENCA. For external exams, Form 8 needs to be completed by February of Year 9. Evidence having been gathered in the previous 2 years. In some cases, it may well be that they don't need a Form 8 because you can give them the access arrangements they need with the ones that don't need to be. In other cases, you may need, and you need a paper trail for that, but in other cases, you might need the Form 8. Any questions?
Yes.
Should I take another slide?
Yeah, I do.
Just put it on me.
How long do I have to wait before I find out the applications?
Can I just say something?